You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where Krishna talks about translating documents at scale and even preserving formatting. You're not going to miss it. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show. We're talking all about translating documents at scale and preserving formatting with Azure Translator. Krishna, how you doing, my friend? Welcome back.
Thanks, Ed. Glad to be part of your show again.
Fantastic. So tell us who you are and what you do for those that haven't met you yet.
Yeah. I'm Krishna. I am the Principal Program Manager for Translator Service. I own the service, so any good stuff you see in Translator and credits goes to my team, and any bad stuff, blame it on me.
Awesome. So let's talk about document translation. What is it? What's new since we last chatted?
Yes. Before I jump to what's new, I would just like to introduce what we did in the Build conference. In the Build conference, we announced general availability of document translation feature, which translates documents in a minute. Document translation enables user to translate volumes of large documents in variety of file formats easily into single or multiple target languages, preserving the layout and structure as in the original file format. Do you have a document in mixed language? No problem. Document translation would automatically detect the languages in the document and get it translated for you. You could also translate a single document into multiple languages in a single request. You could also bring your own translation memory, which you have built over a period of time, and build custom models and use it to translate documents. Or if you have a simple problem, just create a simple custom glossary and apply it during document translation.
I mean, this is really cool. It's literally the Swiss Army knife of translating stuff, but in situ, meaning in the actual document itself. Is that right?
Absolutely. Well,
here's a question. I mean, how do you prioritize the features that you build? I didn't ask you that last time, but maybe you can help us out this time.
I would say the document translation is an outcome of co-creation by customers actively participating in our private preview and public preview programs. We have been working with our partners for more than 6 months. Our partners showed tremendous confidence on us as the product evolved, addressing their needs. They provided us insights on the use case scenarios, which helped us to tune the product. I would like to take this opportunity to thank our partners who helped us to build this solution.
That's cool.
For example, if you want to say which file format we support, limits on the service, optimal time to translate documents, or direct outcome of our customer needs. In the slide, I have listed a few functionalities which are added primarily to support specific customer use case scenarios. Ability to translate multilingual documents. We didn't have that prior to the preview. We added it now. Secure access to storage by enabling managed identity and establishing trust between translator and storage resources. This is one of the top asks from the enterprise customers. Support AAD-based authentication, which enables enterprise to roll out document translation capability in their own apps so that they can control which employee can use the app and not. We won't stop here. We have a huge backlog to enhance the document translation offering further more in coming days.
I mean, this is cool. I love the idea of building a service that customers want, right? This is,
yes.
I mean, it feels like the right thing to do. So I have a question.
Interestingly, Seth, the customer was giving very active feedback during the development and telling us, hey, this is what we want, you fix it. And it's so amazing.
Yeah, I absolutely love this. Can you show us how this works?
Sure. The flow is simple. So all you need to do is upload the source document into a container and then make a request to our service. And the service pulls the document from the Azure Blob storage and it returns an ID and use this ID to pull the documents, pull the status for the service. And once the document translation completes the translation, it puts back the translated document into the container and you can pull it and use it. And this all happens in Ziffy. The service comes with a few operations. There are a few get operations which will provide the capabilities of the service, like what are the document formats supported, glossary formats supported, and a single post operation to start the translation, and a bunch of get operations which shows you the status at different levels, either at the document level or the job level.
Right. And this is cool. What is it? Can I see like what do the requests look like?
Oh, it's a simple request. So if you want to translate all documents, all you just need in three values to be passed to the request: the source URL, target URL, and the target language, and that's it. And if you want to translate a specific file, all you provide is a storage type file, and then we recognize, hey, this is a file, and then we translate the file. And it doesn't stop here. There are much more optional parameters like translating using a custom translation model. You can pass on the custom translation ID. And if you want to translate using glossaries, you can pass on the glossaries. And if you want to translate a particular folder within a container, then you can have filters to go more deep into it.
This is really cool. And now the part that I like the most is that you're actually doing the translation, but inside of the document with the same format. Is that right?
Absolutely. So see here. So look at the source and translator document. You could see how well the structure and layout are retained in the translator document, including the column layouts, font styling, font color, tables, etc.
I mean, this is cool. Can you show this working in a live setting?
Yes, it's my pleasure to do that. So here is a client app which we built using the document translation API. I would be translating a Word document and a PowerPoint to demonstrate, right, hey, we will be able to translate multiple file formats. And then I'm going to show it and store it in the AI show folder. So it's empty just for the record. And then I say translate documents. And the app uploaded the document to the blob storage, and then it's polling for the status. And then the translation started.
Yeah, so this is cool. So it's that whole process.
It's all completed.
Oh, wow. I was trying to talk and it's already done. So this whole process, it uploads it to the blob. The service goes ahead and does a translation. It puts it in the blob, and then you download it. Let's see what's in the docs.
Exactly. So let me show that. So it's opening my other machine. So this is what it translated.
Oh my goodness. And this is literally the slides that we're looking at, right?
Yeah, a version of the slide. The only the color styling is different.
That is okay. So cool.
And the other file is the Word document, which I had in the...
Oh, my goodness.
So you could see a Word document, a PowerPoint, and it's all got translated in few seconds and preserving the layout and structure. And the goodness is this client app, we would be soon putting it in the GitHub as open source, so that the developers can pick it up and enhance it further. And not only that, we do provide code samples in popular languages, and also providing SDK in Python and .NET.
That's cool. So that's what you're showing, the developer experience slide. There's code samples, there's C# API, there's Python, Java, JavaScript, and Go. To do all this is cool. And then the other thing that I like about it is that you have it. Tell us about the SDKs.
Okay, so the SDKs right now we have in Python and .NET. These are in beta stage, and in a couple of weeks we plan to release it to production, and so you all can play with it.
Awesome. So where can people go to find out more? I'm sure you got a ton of information that people can use.
Yes.
There it is.
It's a huge list, and the documentation for all translator offerings. You can go here. We have text translation, document translation, how to build custom translator, all over here. And we have the Python kit and .NET kit. And the coolness is we don't persist any of the customer data. used for translation. So we have a stringent requirement on the translator follows no trace policy, and you can find more details over here.
That's amazing. So the documents, it's basically translate, send it back, eyes off. We don't know what it is.
Yep.
That is amazing. I'll put a little link here for people that would like to find out more, not just the stuff that you just saw. Let me get these links up here so people can look at them. Ton of good information. Krishna, thank you so much for spending some time with us, my friend.
Thanks, Abe.
Awesome. Well, you've been learning all about translate documents, how to translate documents at scale and preserve formatting with Azure Translator. It's been a joy to be with you. Hopefully, we'll see you next time. Take care, my friends.